very common. But what matches very well is this. This couch works very well with red fruits, works very well with spicy pepper. Don't forget, this is going to be warm, colorful, and mixed with ice cream. We're going to combine with it. Therefore, it could be a yogurt ice cream or a coconut ice cream. It could be anything. Now, what we have is this. As I said, a quick twist. What happened is the flavors are playing now. Less time in the pan, hot temperature, short and easy. And the maturity, the smell, the flavors are playing now. Therefore, leave it for about 5 minutes to infuse. And what do we do next? We put some ice cream into that.
Oh. Mm.
That sounds good.
And now, it doesn't matter what type of ice cream I'm using today, as such. Trying to find an ice cream which
doesn't
matter.
That's really clever, though, out of stock.
Because they are, yeah. Now. And the good thing about today, or the time of now, is the invention, the fact people are moving on with so much wet kitchen equipment, utensils, you can froth, you can mix, you can do things by, you know, RV moving your fingers. And now, it used to be a time that having a good ice cream had to depend on a lot of sugar to keep it soft in the freezer. I know it's unsilly, but this is true. Or having a lot of cream, make it nice and, you know, rich. And this is not an issue anymore. I think there's ways of trying to lower down. Using salt with sugar in ice cream is horrific. Absolutely not necessary. Therefore, now you can make, you can actually combine and get a nice sorbet by having the red fruits, using the sugar of the fruit, which is easy to keep it soft. Or having an ice cream with a local of nice stuff at the top. And that's what I'm saying. Before, and people are working harder now, they're not sure. What we do is now, this is smelling fantastic. It's very colorful. Now we're having a combination of hot and cold. Importantly.
Wow, it looks absolutely fantastic.
We haven't even tried it yet. And the good thing about this is you get a lot of liquid, natural liquid, it goes back to the way you handle ingredients. Look at that. Nothing of fat, nothing of salt, nothing of sugar, hardly anything. And it's basically the food itself.
All natural.
Natural. And then what we do, we use obviously freshness from nature. It doesn't have to be mint or liquor. It can be anything.
So guys, get your questions ready. Anybody, yes. Any questions for Jean-Christophe? We'd love to answer. Maybe you want to ask a question about him. He has a cooking academy. He's got lots of experience, you know, in the trade. Maybe you want to ask him some questions in that. Maybe you have something specific, like this lady Anne here, who's asked for advice on a wedding cake that she's making. Anything you might want to ask him, I'll be coming around to you in a minute. Do you have a little think?
Now the talk should come up. And as I said, a problem of humidity. Did you see what happened early on? It's bound to be obviously an issue with sugar. And yeah. I can see clearly the caramel is getting a little bit sticky on my finger. This is very good. That should last at least 4 hours. Minimum 4 hours.
Okay.
Then you put it on the top. And that's what you get. A nice, little, exciting...
That's what it's
on. Yeah, I think that deserves a round of applause.
Hey.
Fantastic.
Thank you. Once again, it's practice, yeah? I don't want to hear somebody saying, well, that's not for me. Believe me, anything is possible. If you've got time.
You make it look so easy.
Yeah.
Excellent. Does anyone have any questions for Jean-Christophe? Anything you'd like to ask him?